My lung cancer hero is Rodney Wellman. Rodney was my husband, my best friend, my high school sweetheart, the father of our two beautiful daughters, and the sack of the Secret Service Phoenix field office. With all of that, he was diagnosed with lung cancer in October of 2018. That became his biggest fight. He became a great advocate and fundraiser to make everyone aware of how important it was to put up a fight against lung cancer. He ran a trail run 1 year after his diagnosis in 2019. He raised over $30,000. I miss Rodney so much every day, and I won't want anyone to have to go through the loss that my girls and I have gone through. We're so proud of Rodney for everything he did, and for that reason, he's our hero.
Susan Wellman, thank you so much for being with us today. We were thrilled to get your submission for the Lung Cancer Hero Award. And, you know, so many of us at GoTo Foundation had the honor of meeting your family, meeting Rodney, and we are thrilled to announce that your submission is the winner of the Lung Cancer Hero Award. And although Rodney died on January 5th of this year, no one represents the spirit of this award more than him. And we're honored to award it to him posthumously this year and are thrilled that you're here.
Thank you. One thing about Rodney is nothing ever came easy. I mean, from football to getting this position at the Secret Service to finally getting the sack position was destined to have at some point. It did not come easy, but Rodney had a heart of, he would push on and push on and push on, and that's what drove him through the lung cancer. So he just had a common theme throughout his whole life.
What drove Rodney to want to be public and share his story?
The stigma of lung cancer, because Rodney had never smoked. He's not a big drinker. He was a runner. He was always an athlete. And that's what drove him. Because of the stigma, there wasn't enough research to be done and there wasn't enough money to be had. And he wanted so much just to get that word out there so that people did not have to face what he was facing and ever have to face that stigma that, it's a smoking disease. It's not always a smoking disease. That was what upset him the most. And he just really wanted to get out there, no matter what energy it took out of him, that he was going to use this as a reason that he got it. And that was, it didn't have to be a death sentence. There was a reason why this was put in his life. He also wanted to show people you could live with it. And that was another thing. That was the back end of it. You don't have to curl up in a ball, that you can do Javelina 100K trail runs and come out okay. And that was the other end of it. And that's why he never took a day off of work. He wanted to show the guys that worked for him, you can do this, we can do this. This is not, I'm not dying, I can do this. I promise you, I will be here until I can't. And that was his motivation. I thank you for honoring him again. And I don't even know what he would say. He would probably be humbled and say he didn't deserve it.
Probably. No. Yes. Probably. Who better to really encompass that? And, it may not be a happy ending, which is unfortunately the case a lot of the time, but what is so notable to me is how people live while they're here, yes. That's that heroic piece, is what decisions do people make while they're living?
Yeah.
And how are they going to live? Yeah. And that's what's inspiring. Thank you for sharing him with us and for sharing your heart. He's impacted more than one person. So he's, I think his goal was more than met.
Thank you. Thank you.